YouTubers, Vic here, good old Montalbert, how are you going? I had a great tag on Facebook from Tresemme1, Wendy.
Hello.
And I did mention in the comments that this would make a great video. And basically, it was name the 12 albums that have stayed with you in some way or another. Now, and I started thinking about it, and I started rattling off a list, and I went, hell, grab a camera. So, here I am. Now, it may end up being more than 12. I also have to say somewhat why it was, well, Dark Side of the Moon, because it is just awesome. It's one of them. Actually, I must admit, Pink Floyd, particularly Dark Side of the Moon, Wish You Were Here. I remember having, when I had my cassette deck and I had my own copy of the album. Sometimes when I was by myself in my room, I would actually sing and in key in the same pitch the guitar solo for Shine On Your Crazy Diamond. I can't do it now. I try and I hurt my throat. Although I can sing high, if you saw my last video. Thanks for watching for the four people that thumbed it down. But getting back on topic, Pink Floyd will have to be, as I said, Dark Side, Moon, because of Eclipse, Great Gig in the Sky, Us and Them, Time. Is there anything else? Nah. These are not in particular order. Wish We're Here. Brilliant album. Love Shine On Your Crazy Diamond. And of course, the title track. Have a Cigar's pretty cool too. And later, Floyd will have to be Moments of Lapse of Reason, The Wall, harrowing it is, I do adore Goodbye Blue Sky. It's what I relate, it's the song I relate to about being someone who survives trauma and, you know, has flashbacks. It's really, you know, I think I even sang a line of it in an old video somewhere. Alan Parsons Project. Particularly Tales of Mystery and Imagination, Edgar Allan Poe. I remember kids seeing the album at the end and the mummified image, that image burned in my consciousness, and that album has as well. Casco Montalbán. I must admit, seeing those four thumbs down on Army Dreamers, I was starting to sing the Casco Montalbán. By the last breath of the four winds that blow, I'll have my revenge on Fortunato. Basically, if you don't know, basically, you know, this guy coats this guy down to a cell and then drinks wine and then then bricks him into his own personal catacomb alive. What are these chains that are binding our arms? While that's being sung, Eric Wolfson comes in, part of you dies, each brick I lay. It's like, whoa. You know, say me the light in the name of you, you'll feel your life slipping away. Yeah. And of course, The Fall of the House of Usher, brilliant little classical, modern classical piece in a way. And To One in Paradise. I do love To One in Paradise, you know. If I could see the sky above, and my mind be set free, as wild white horses reach the shore, I'll stand alone and oversee. I would love to do that, but again, it's Eric and Alan, there's, you know, overlapping track and all that too, so like Cards Come On Tomato. Turn of a Friendly Card. Turn the Friendly Card, yes, Time always still brings a tear to my face. most likely the song I'll have at my funeral. If anybody gets there. Please, don't be in a hurry. And Price to Pay, the whole Turn the Cards week, and all that. Eve is pretty cool. iRobot's pretty cool. Stereosomy, I love Life in the World. That's a beautiful song. Those albums have stayed with me, although I nearly had the whole discography. Oh, Try and Think Once. Siren Song. Siren Song. Yes. 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 Love it. I think I sent that to someone in my Facebook inbox once. Yes, of course, Eve, because of Damned If I Do. Oh, of course, Pyramid, What Goes Up, and I'm a Gamma, and The Eat Will Rise Again. Mama, thank you. This is going to be a long vlog, folks, we're talking music. So, what else? I've got Kiss, Best of the Solo Albums, Australian Edition, yes, all the solo albums itself, Harder Than Hell for Parasites, double platinum for that version of 100,000 years. Of course, Alive 1 and 2. I think this is Alive 1 has the epic Peter Chris John solo in the middle of 100,000 years. Of course, Dressed to Kill, that is my ultimate favourite because of Rock and Roll All Night, and of course, Rock Bottom. The intro alone, you can chuck the rest of the song as far as I'm concerned, but just that intro riff I could listen to. Ace Frehley solo album, Fractured Mirror. God, I'll have listened to all four parts of Fractured Mirror over the years from his solo albums. What else from Kiss? Oh, Music from the Elder. I know it's a concept album, it's one of the most pagan albums I've ever heard them do. You know, it's the one that divides Kiss fans in half. It really does. It was a great idea. It was underrated, and if Kiss had more creative control in it, it would have been a kick-ass album. But I think they made up for it in Creatures of the Night and post makeup and all that. So, what other albums have stayed with me? Just thinking of my old record. Oh, Cat Stevens, of course. Tears from the Fire Cat. Mine is broken. How can I tell you? And everyone's going to smirk. But yes, we know. Ruby Love. You know, If I Could Laugh as well. There was also an album called The World of Cat Stevens and Father and Son, Kitty, I'm Gonna Get Me a Gun. I Love My Dog, and apparently my mother had a copy of this, and I was just playing Wore It Out, you know, when I was like 11, 12, my mum said, went to a second-hand record store, found it again, and said, do you remember this? I said, oh, vaguely, she said, you wore it, my copy. And so, you know, Cat Stevens. A lesser known Olivia Newton-John album that stayed with me, and I really wish I had my copy again, or might search through where I recorded it on cassette from CD Gaia, because I love the title track and a few other tracks. I think basic that. Oh my goodness. Houses of the Holy. Led Zeppelin, For No Quarter. The Doors, oh my god. Look at the woman has the discography. American Prayer, Waiting for the Sun, Not to Touch the Earth, Alvin Doney's Adagio in G minor. No, oh, sorry, A flat minor. Waiting for the Sun itself, The Spanish Caravan, just to name a few tracks off that one. Morrison Hotel for the Whiskey song, of course. I could go on about the Doors if I wanted to. I was nicknamed Miss Morrison. Yeah, of course, you got your stand to light my fire and all that, but don't forget, you know, Waltz to the Western, you know, Texas Rain, the Big Beat, and Awake, and, you know, Bird of Prey. All those less little gems that didn't get seen to. Oh, my goodness. So as I said, these are albums and artists, they're just pouring out of me. AC/DC, High Voltage. Why not? Well, High Voltage. Band that not many people know much about outside of Australia and New Zealand, called Tizzle, particularly 20th Century, set, you know, 20th Century, the album itself. Oh, and East, of course, for Cheap Wine and all that. So, but 20th Century and Saturday Nights, Lear Grey, that album sort of stayed with me when I had it. Oh my goodness, what else? I was thinking what I collected a lot of. Doors, Pink Floyd, that Kiss, I think there's a lot of it. There's so many albums, but they're the albums I could think of offhand. There's, oh my goodness, how could I forget? Oxygen, Jean-Michel Jarre, Magnetic Field, Zulaki, something like that. Rendezvous, with Houston Leon album. Pull them my thinking. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant stuff. Well, Jean-Michel Jarre is just a craftsman. If you've ever, I've only seen him on video when they've been on art shows and all that, but seeing the concerts themselves, it's just remarkable. You know, it's a very visual feast, and the laser harp and his light up keyboard and everything like that. But Oxygen, Stay With Me, and all that. David Bowie, Let's Dance, Let's Dance, Scary Monsters, of course, Ashes to Ashes. Let's Dance, the whole damn album, quite frankly, but Modern Love, China Girl, everything like that. What else? Of course, Bowie, Ziggy Stardust, and of course, early Bowie, let's not forget Life on Mars and Space Oddity. And then there's the great Berlin period with Brian Eno with, you know, Heroes and John Amoni dancing and DJ and all that stuff too. So yeah, the albums has come down to artists and singles and all that. long story short, I could go on forever and ever. But yeah, that's just the tip of the iceberg. Oh, one of the few, and I must admit, one period of my life that's there, and it still somewhat stays with me. And it's Culture Club. Culture Club. I'm not kidding. I had a crush on the drummer. What is it about Blackhead, man? Meanwhile, awkward moment when you find out that John was George's boyfriend, and you go, okay, it's been nice, it's been real. Aha, as well, my goodness, down this road, Velvet, Summer Shots on TV, Looking for the Whales, Lost Soft Rains of April, Cry Wolf, Living Daylights, oh, good grief, Forever Not Yours, you know, things like that. They're great. That's a great artist and some albums in there too. Rick Springfield in the way. Rick Springfield is my first big teenage crush. Again, blackhead guys. What is it? I'm married a redhead. And yeah, I loved his first album and Living in Oz and all that. Success has eyes. Yeah, Working Class Dog. I actually like Inside Sylvia and Jessie's Girl. But, you know, the tongue-in-cheek song Bruce, about how you got mixed up with Bruce Springsteen. Early Rick Springfield. Zoots. Google it. So get on YouTube. Zoot. Z-O-O-T. The Zoot. El Naripi. Do yourself a favour. Really. Kick-ass version of it. Not bad. Rick Springfield's in there. In guitar. Speak to the Sky. Great little gospel song. Whatnot. So... I could go on forever about this, but thanks for this, Wendy. I'm most likely to have talked the leg off the table, and I could talk forever about more music. Maybe you could ask me. Yes, no, maybe, you know. But they're the things that the albums that have come to me right now. So I better go because someone's got telly up. Okay. But thanks for watching. Bye for now.